way through. He's going to hit the inside. Can he get the power down early? Kallio's going to come through on the inside of a Goethe. Goethe's relinquishes. Is that a mistake? Could he have just ticked the button?
Immediately when I arrived to this team 2011, that all the guys and was really friendly for me, and the atmosphere was good. And now step by step, all the time it's getting better because we have been working now many days and the years and the weeks together.
For me, it's the best Moto2 team in the paddock. You know, for everything, it's like a big family with Marc and Neri. You know, and you know they got the car team now, the Moto3 team, and. You know, I just feel kind of at home there, but also when we get to the track, the work is really professional.
Especially last year, we had some chatter issue and problems many track, and that one disturbed quite a lot to make a better result. So this year we didn't really have this, and also we set up the bike a little bit different way, and looks like that now the level where we are and the pace settings what we have, it's quite okay.
Bike this year, it's not a big difference from the last year's chassis because you know it's so good, so it stays very similar. The good thing is the size for me, it's not bigger than most of the others, but the way they made the bike makes it feel bigger, so that makes me feel more comfortable.
I think nobody really think about the other side, you know, when they are big riders and they have the weight on the body, they can use this for the riding, and that's much easier for them. You know, the bike is lighter because they don't have the extra weight and they have the weight on the body, so it's much easier to them to change the direction, and also some places they just change the weight more to the front or more to the rear, and they don't need to close to the throttle, and we need to brake some places because we don't have the weight on the body.
I mean, it's good that they've done something about it, but it's made no difference between me and my competitors, you know, like Espargaro, Luti. These guys, it's the same as last year, but with Mika and Rabat and the smaller guys, you know, it helps. We can see on the straights that they're not making 0.2 of a second in a straight like the back straight here in Jerez.
My first moment, I think, was something which happened in 2005. I believe that when we were fighting really against Thomas Luthi to win the title in 1-5. We were all the season together, really close to the points, and then in the end we lost the title in the 5 points, and in this 5 points we lost also in the Qatar when my teammate overtake me just in the last 50 meters, and that was something that of course it's not so nice memory because we were so close to win the title.
Well, here he comes for the slipstream. Gabor Talmaxi for the victory. The Hungarian is going to take the win as they cross the line. Whoa. He stalked his teammate to the final metres. Gabor Talmaxi wins the Grand Prix of Qatar.
You know, when we had the Tommy Zauer accident in 2010 was probably the worst moment ever in my career. But on the other hand, you have to take it as, you know, this can happen sometimes and you have to be stronger. And this does make me stronger because I know the dangers out there, and the problem with when riders are slowing up, they don't know what can happen, and you know I know what can happen, so for me it makes me more focused and more determined to do my best.
Yeah, the best moments, of course, always is something special, you know, when you won the first race, which was in 1-5 KTM 2005, and that was something that your dream came through, and it was really nice feeling.
Yeah, I think the best moment, you know, is going to be Donington when I won in the 125s.
Scott Redding, still at school. He's rewritten the history books. He's won the British Grand Prix here at Donington Park. Amazing!
I've had a lot of highs and, you know, going through the season and even the beginning this year. I got my first pole position in Texas by 0.6 of a second, was really unexpected. And the battle with pole in Qatar was also you know, it's not like one day bad, one day good. It's really consistent, and this is even more better for me.